this man came that day. If he had said nothing again, God, but God came. And when God said, throw away your stretcher, the man fling it and began to run. And I said, where is your stretcher? He said, you asked us to throw it away. And I threw it away because I will never need it again. And the man said, I'm a doctor. I said, medical doctor. He said, yes. I just came back and they said, there is nothing. After all your pressure, nothing. But still, God came and said, I can change the situation. With God, all things are possible. I don't know where you are sitting down right now. I don't know where you are sitting down right now. But I came to tell you, people may think you will not rise, but I tell you, your God can surprise everybody. I can hear your better amen to that. If Jesus is alive in the altar, every shame you came here with tonight, you are not going home with a shame. Some places in my village before, they said this road, nobody passed through this road. Why? They said a shrine. But now that shrine has become a road. There are places they said this water destroys people. But right now that water, people have built houses there. To tell you nothing stays forever. No man has a final say. Only God has a final say. Man can never be God. Everything created by God dies with time. Only God lives from generation to generation. And from everlasting to everlasting, he remains God. Am I talking to somebody? Only God lives from everlasting to everlasting. So nothing changes God, but he changes our situation. Somebody say amen to that. Number three, the story of Bartimaeus taught us. I want to run fast. The story of Bartimaeus taught us that God cannot change a man's life without his word. God cannot just wake up and change your life without the word. The word. There is power in the word of God. The Bible says one day, Bartimaeus in his frustration heard the voice. Bartimaeus heard it. He heard it that the Savior is coming. He heard it that the Redeemer is coming. Tap your neighbor, say, you are hearing the same word of God now. Stand up and push your neighbor, say, you are hearing the same word of God. But he just had it. He had it. And he believed. Just like the woman on the issue of blood. She had it. She had the word. Just like you are hearing now. In Mark chapter 5, 25. She had it. That a savior has the power to change life. She had it. And she said to herself, if I touch the hem of his garment, I shall be made whole. She didn't say to any man, but she said to herself. In Acts chapter 14, verse 7, there was another paralyzed man who was listening to the word of God of Paul. As Paul the apostle was preaching, the paralyzed man was listening to the word of God. And the Bible said, suddenly Paul saw him right there where he was sitting now. And Paul saw in his eyes that the man believed, that the man had faith. So number one, Paul preached. Number two, Paul saw that the man has faith. And number three, Paul said to the man, get up and express your faith. Rise up in Jesus' name and walk. And the man got up and began to walk. Now Paul did three things. And the man did three things. Number one, Paul preached.